I'm Maggie Dalene. I'm the fuels tech on the Uinta-Wasatch-Cache, Evanston, Mountain View Ranger District. Today we're at the Hoop Lake Burn. This took place in 2016, so 4 years ago. And as you can tell, this area has a lot of diversity in the burn. There's areas that burned really, really hot and areas that didn't burn very hot. This is actually what we look for when we do prescribe burns, that we want that diversity. We're trying to be similar to Mother Nature. And so Mother Nature will burn some spots hot and some places not so hot. And what we really like about this burn is that the areas that it did burn really hot, we're getting a lot of aspen regeneration, which is great for the wildlife habitat. When we do prescribe burns, we don't always get the consumption that we want. And so we'll have pockets that look really great like this that are opening up the aspen stands from the conifer. And then there are other areas that it won't take as well. And it will just burn some of the understory and not put as good of pockets in, but both are doing what we want it to give it that diverse age group of getting different vegetation types in the area.
I am Larisa Yokom. I am an assistant professor of fire ecology at Utah State University. So the idea of heterogeneity, or things that are different across the landscape, is really good for both ecology and also for management. That way the forest has more resilience to all kinds of disturbances like fire, but also insect outbreaks. So if you have more diversity of species and age classes and sizes of trees, the forest can resist some of those impacts a little bit more.
An ideal fire might be a one where you get patches of mortality or overstory mature tree death, and patches where the fire runs along the ground, so that again you get that patchy result where some places you've got nice spot for new aspen to come in, and some places you keep those old trees. So having a mix, again, any kind of mix of ecosystems and ages and species is a really good thing to aim for.